think this is your time?
What's up, everybody? PJ Braun here, president and CEO of Blackstone Labs, Prime Nutrition, and Celestial Bodiez.
TT Fan Club, don't forget that. I am the CEO of Celestial Bodiez. I laughed a little bit when I said that because I accidentally called you the CEO in the videos I was doing with Eric for some of the products for Facebook. But we boosted it anyways.
I was not happy about my appearance a little bit earlier, and I hope that I look good in this video. I was taking some photographs earlier, and my eyes were looking all droopy. And I might have to talk to Lamore, the lady that put the little injections in here.
Whatever, 5 minutes later, no, 5 seconds later, I took him into my office where the lighting's better and took a picture of him where he looks extremely handsome.
I was just smiling.
Just took a very bad picture.
Took a very bad picture.
We'll just erase it from memory.
I'm not photogenic. So. We'll talk a little bit more about photos later, but let's get into this. I feel like we have not done this in a long time.
No.
I hope that's not the case. I hope you guys are not thinking that we're taking too long. I was meaning to do more of them, and instead we're doing, it seems, less. This is going to go back to July 5th, the day after the 4th of July, three-day weekend. We had an exciting week that week, and people have been saying they want to see more of the business side of things. They don't want to see as much of the goofy stuff, but they want to see business and they want workout stuff, which are things that coincidentally we were not showing you of lately. So
we do more of our workouts with we used to. I feel like people like that.
You will see in this episode some discussion on the proper way to handle the sampling and the free samples that the sales reps get a little crazy with when they give them out to the stores, because they're not sometimes thinking that I am paying for all those samples. Anywhere from the low side, 30 cents, but more realistically, 45 cents per sample. And sometimes these guys will give out thousands of samples. So
that adds up.
It adds up. Got to think about that. Pinch those pennies a little bit. Also, there's a lot of stuff going on with our Facebook ads.
That's what I'm trying to find, but I can't. They moved it now that it's approved. Like, they moved where the creative is.
What if you click it in here?
See, I couldn't even use the word cellulite. Because I had the word cellulite before.
So you can't use cellulite either?
It got knocked. Because I changed it to get rid of unwanted cellulite.
Oh, I can't believe that either.
So I changed it to this, proven over and over again, which I know it's stupid. I just want to see what we can get through this. And ours is the only one containing tripeptide 1.
Mm-hmm.
So we know that those two phrases made it okay.
Okay.
And we got approved. I know this is very frustrating, but I know we want to figure it out so we can advertise. But.
All right, well, we'll see how it goes.
Another warning, this is what they said. You can't do anything in age, height, gender, body shape, body size. And then these are my two notes, like no cleavage at all, period.
Yeah, we've learned that. I mean,
just for Facebook.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So frustrating.
It is, man, but we're smart enough people here to figure it out.
Yeah, and of course we'll figure it out. It's just frustrating that you can't just say directly what it does. It's a anti-cellulite cream, you know.
Well,
so
if you also post things about Donald Trump, they get censored on Facebook more than Hillary things do. They got caught like a week and a half ago doing that or something.
That's amazing. So. Okay, well, thank you.
Yep.
Glad that we are able to get an ad out finally on that one.
Yep. And it's going to probably happen a lot more in the future, you know that, but and they keep getting us approved, like, at least we know more, like, we're learning that, just how sensitive they are.
Mm-hmm.
We have to be really vague. And Matt Rossi, actually, we were talking about this earlier in the morning, he had some really good ways to get around some of these words that we want to use.
Okay.
And I'm going to, before these, I want to get a list of them. He had really creative.
Yeah, let's talk about that.
His biggest one was, like, slim down.
I want to know, because for me, when I do these at night at like 1 in the morning, yeah, and I do like 5 of them, and then I wake up with them all being disapproved, it makes me very angry. Yeah. So.
Well, we'll send you an email, and you can just like save it in like a favorite or something.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
We'll
have so you don't do any of that here, because you do it at night.
What if like he turned?
Cool. Thank you.
I noticed, because I get email notifications at 4 in the morning saying ads created. So then I get one at 7 a.m. saying ad disapproved.
Yeah, it's usually like her being like, don't stay up too late doing that, and me being like, I just want to do like 5. And waking up in the morning lately to them being shut down.
Wednesday. We had Linda Durbesson came here. We did our Linda Durbesson announcement. Very exciting. She did such a great job with Celestial Bodiez that I wanted her to come over to Blackstone, but she was with another company. So as soon as she was done with her contract with that other company, I came in and I said, I would like to offer you a better deal. And because she was just really so happy with how she was getting treated on the Celestial Bodiez side of things, that she felt like she was part of our family, which is how we always want everybody to feel. So we committed the robbery and made it all.
Snatched her up.
Yep.
She does really, really good job. Like, she gives us so much content for like every social media page we have.
She goes above and beyond.
Yeah, she does really great. So like, if I'm looking for something to post on any of our social medias, I'll just go to her page and find exactly what I need. And she is one of the best of our Heavenly Bodiez that is the best at showing the scrunch.
Yes. Today, I'm standing here with the stunning Linda Durbesson, and some of you guys probably already know who she is because she's got a bazillion followers on Facebook and another, like, what, 500,000 on Instagram or something like that?
Yeah, we are reaching 4 million now on my fan page. But
it's a lot. If you don't know her, you might have also seen her in a lot of the Celestial Bodiez stuff, which brings me to why we are here now. She has done so above and beyond as far as working hard for the company, posting, spreading the word, talking on Snapchat. And to me, I'm all about loyalty and respect and people putting in the work. I always tell people when they reach out to me that I'll typically sign them for trial phases and see how much they want to work and how much they prove themselves. And the people that do prove themselves, I treat them very, very good. And I know that my girls will also back me up on that. Well, for Blackstone Labs, we make awesome products for everybody. However, a lot of people have said, like, oh, why don't you make products for girls? I'm like, what are you talking about? All of our products, with the exception of the pro hormones, are for girls. So I've decided that I need more awesome girls that work hard and want to prove themselves to me to get the word out on Blackstone Labs products, which brings me to Linda. She's already proved herself amazing with Celestial Bodiez, so it seemed like a no-brainer. And I brought her in here and talked about the future together, hooked her up with a ton of products, and now we are putting the message out there that Linda is officially with Blackstone Labs. And whenever I sign somebody to Blackstone Labs, I'm bringing them onto Prime as well. So you'll be able to get discounts on all the products through her. If you follow her, she'll be able to educate you on them. And we're going to be doing training series, all sorts of fun stuff based around Linda.
Okay, so I'm very happy to be here and to be part of the family, because this is what I was looking for in terms of a company, a supplement company. And I'm really excited to represent Prime Nutrition and Blackstone. And so I'm so excited. So I'm already with Celestial Bodiez, which I love. And that's it. I mean, really, I'm out of words because I'm really, I'm really happy to be here and to be part of PJ, to give me a chance to show what I can bring to his company, so, and to Celeste as well, because they all, when we talk about PJ, it's also Celeste.
She is, like I said, she goes above and beyond, and that's extremely important. Our contracts are based around Instagram and Facebook, but she actually does a ton on Snapchat also. So when we see people that are really going above and beyond like that, we take notice, and those are the people that we want associated with us, and those are the people that we want to reward. You will also see her doing some stuff with Celestial Bodiez.
What's up, you guys? I'm Celeste, the Celestial Bodiez CEO. I'm standing here with the fabulous, amazing Linda Durbesson, and she is one of our star athletes, you could say, or star Heavenly Bodiez, one of our stunners. And we're actually standing here behind the scenes in the warehouse. We have our trusty Brittany helping us put away some of our new arrivals, which is the point of this video. We are doing a huge Lunar Series expansion. Mm-hmm. And if you are not aware, the Lunar Series is our newest collection, and it's a different fabric blend than all of our other stuff. And it's been crazy popular, so we decided to expand the whole series. We have heather items. It comes in heather, charcoal, and this brand new, I'm calling it midnight, but it's like a navy color. Linda's wearing it here in the low rise. These are a new item. So we're gonna release these. We have a high waist capri. She's wearing the low rise scrunch. Get all up in there, Eric. And so we're releasing these, and we're gonna have a matching bra and a high waist capri option. So another overwhelmingly popular item is we released charcoal capris low rise, and then we decided to release them in our full length low rise style. We have charcoal bras, we have high waist charcoal pants, And the most popular of them all is our Heather items. So we have Heather bras, Heather shorts, Heather lowers, Heather capris, and we're expanding every style we have. And we will actually be restocking some of our really, really super popular stuff that we released, and it sold out in like 10 days because it was so popular, which is like the fastest anything has ever sold out. So we're super stocked up for you guys, and we're even releasing these new never before seen totally custom tops. They're crops, they're a new material. We haven't used this before, but it's amazing. They'll be available in black and white. These aren't part of the Lunar series, but they will be released when we do the big Lunar series expansion. So we're gonna do a big shoot, and everything is gonna be up and running in the next, I wanna say the next 3 weeks. And then right after that, we have another huge release coming, but it's a surprise, even though some of you already know. And then, what's that? Oh, and here's actually Linda in the white. This is the white crop, which we have right here.
This is edited pictures, yeah. So this is.
And then after that, I went and I played basketball.
Oh. I came up shooting hoops in the hood and cheap clothes on milk crates where I practice my shot. Remember NBA Jam, yeah, Dirty. People listen to me.
They don't on the court, I noticed. At least not the guy.
Holding it.
Half court shot, switch, look, nothing but net.
Try to take a three.
Walk up the court.
Not running.
About pound! What was that, Brett? What happened?
I really don't want him to continue this basketball. I don't know what to even call it, because he came home all beat up and like was limping the next day, and then I had to like nurse his blisters on his foot and like go buy blister pads and make him soak his feet and stuff. So hopefully maybe he'll get some better shoes or just warm up or not even play. I don't know.
Well, I used to play basketball, and I played into high school, and I was pretty good. I wasn't like all state or anything, but I was a pretty good basketball player, and I was also a lot different shaped back then. And one thing that I learned about playing basketball on Wednesday is that I am very out of shape. And regardless of doing cardio every day, I am still very out of
You're
shape.
You're not in that like sprint shape, you know?
I am out of shape.
Cutting and we gotta like go get you outside and do some drills.
Well, I am gonna now play every Wednesday. And I showed up at the courts like I've been playing for the past 15 years, when in fact I have not played at all. And because of that, I was very bad at basketball, and I've suffered numerous injuries in that game, but it was fun. It was very fun. And it was good bonding for all of the employees, because it was all guys that work here.
So we had Deanna on Wednesdays. We always get her massages, and she came over, and we're telling her about the basketball, and he was telling us about everyone who was good, who was sucked, who got hurt, who fell, whatever. And as he was telling us like about how funny Sammy was, Sammy texted Deanna asking for a massage like immediately.
He heard him. Sammy is too jacked to play basketball. Yeah. He's all muscle. Yeah, there's a funny video coming. We're gonna do a separate basketball video, so that should be ready pretty soon. You guys will appreciate that one. Thursday, Cody Montgomery came into town. I wanted to get some content with him, so there was a bunch of Cody stuff that'll be sprinkled out over the next couple weeks that you guys will see.
What's up, everybody? We're gonna go get some lunch here in Boca. We're gonna go try to get some healthy options, hopefully some chicken, some rice, something like that. We'll see what we can get ourselves into. Maybe a good hamburger, hot dog.
Hamburger
for Trevor over here. Gotta get the gains.
So I got some chicken street tacos. Get some good protein in, and I got me a little soup. Start feeling a little bit better. I feel a little bit under the weather, so my go-to when I get sick is juiced up, followed by some soup. So we'll enjoy our lunch, courtesy of Blackstone Labs, and keep on following along for the day.
Big bars are awesome, although some people don't like them, but they're bullshit.
See, this is one of the customers of the racket.
This is the
famous.
This is the new Ross's.
Every time I'm here, it gets bigger.
Look at the fridge. Open the fridge.
Shit, this is like the real deal.
Yeah, you haven't been here in a while.
Yeah, you know, you guys seriously stepped it up.
I have an LLC.
Yeah? Oh, no shit.
That's amazing.
Shit is like for real, the real deal.
You get thirsty, come over here, get hydrated.
Yeah, it's gonna have like an open house day so everybody can come experience it all.
I thought about advertising externally, but I didn't want people running, walking into the warehouse. To be honest with you, in my old office, it would have been more acceptable because they didn't have to walk through the warehouse to get to it. Yeah. But now you have to walk through everywhere.
I still think you should make a Yelp.
A Yelp? Everybody would just give me all these opinions. And then I would show up on Google Maps. I could technically do a Google Maps now that I have a, you know, an actual business.
Did you actually make an LLC about
it? Yeah.
Oh, shit, yeah.
So have you researched some of that kind of stuff? Because you probably just
I have a lawyer that took care of it.
Because I'm
he's a lawyer.
They have it on retainer for the racket.
I trade SEO.
Just in case, like, I drink two monsters and I have a seizure or something?
Because I have an LLC in Texas, for sure.
How did you do it on being on the road?
It just was not getting anxiety. The hardest.
Because I'm like very schedule oriented.
Me too. Traveling, literally, I was home like 36 hours a week, so the rest of the time was just travel. It's very hard, but like when you just get, because I was so used to only traveling and I was never home.
It's probably weird to hope you actually be home.
Yeah, it was like weird, so it's just the mindset you get in. So if you're like constantly traveling, you're just already in that mode. So it's harder to be home for a long period of time and then like travel, and you know, so it's just a mindset.
That is like my biggest thing, because I was good, because I was traveling like a lot during March, April, May, and then I kind of chilled out for like a month and a half now.
Yeah, you know what I mean? It's a total mindset. When you're in the mode, like you just have to be super organized. Like I would literally repack my suitcase like 2-3 times a day, not kidding, because like we would in the morning when we leave the hotel, and then again at the arena, and then sometimes before I left the arena to drive. And
you had to book all your own like flights.
So our flights were booked, but we had to rent our own cars and do our own hotels and stuff like that. Yeah, it was like convenient because you got to stay with whoever you wanted, your travel partner, and where you wanted. But it also sucked because like you had to do all the driving yourself and worry about booking stuff. Yeah, but it's just, geez.
Gotta get in the system.
Yeah.
So you know those girls on that TV show?
Yeah, I worked with all of them. Every single one of them I worked with. Yeah, and the ones that are newer were in the developmental that I like. Briefly met. Yeah. I can't even watch it because it's like.
Not real.
Yeah, and they make them out to be such assholes. Like, some of them are, but it's like.
They want
like,
personalities on the.
Yeah,
on the show
and
whatever,
I like
and
worked.
Probably,
I was still working there for like 6 months before the show started. Oh. I wrestled with all of them, but when the show started, I was still there for like 6 months, but I was like kind of on my way out. And it was super annoying to have the E cameras backstage because there was already all the WWE stuff, like especially on the live days. So it was super fucking annoying. Like they would be in your way and they would be like trying to shoot stuff for the show, but the E show, and it was never supposed to like collide. It was never supposed to be two separate things. That's the girl, the Total Diva show storylines are never supposed to intercept with like the WWE storylines, but then they totally meshed and it was like horrible.
That's crazy.
Yeah, but I mean, I'm still friends with some of them. I just like never really talk. Like when they're in town, I didn't this last time.
They're so busy, probably.
Yeah, because you go from like traveling constantly to like when you go home, they film you there too. Because they do it in seasons though.
Yeah.
Like they just film for a few months and then they're off and then they do it again. So
that's crazy. That's a lot.
I don't know how they did it. Like I never wanted to be a part of it at all. Yeah. Because it was way too much.
Yeah.
Because like I was champ at the time, and so when you're usually like when you're relevant, you're booked for everything, like appearances, every live show. I was, it probably like screwed me over in the end because like, because I wasn't a part of it, I wasn't a part of any of the storylines on TV for like the last 6 months I was there. So But I mean, I was ready to sleep anyways, because, you know, we were getting married. And yeah, so it was time, but I can't watch a show.
Back to like what I was saying earlier about me being like old-fashioned romantic type. I like to like, you know, it's good to see like a couple in love and happy, and everybody should, you know, everybody should be able to feel like the star once in a while and have that treatment and get to do fun stuff. And I know like Justin's really good, you know, so like I've never had any girl that wasn't like, oh my God, I love these pictures after. So if I could do that for you in exchange for you making my star happy, then I'm very happy to do it.
She looks good, man. She's been dieting.
Yeah, you look amazing. You're super lean. I mean, not that you did look the last time.
I was a little thick. Super lean. I got my pictures. Yeah.
Also, you get to meet Amber. I don't know if you guys have met Amber yet. That is the bookkeeper that I hired. A couple
great
new
fashion sense.
Couple new, she does have a great fashion sense. And you know what? She's very classy. She always comes like dressed to the nines to work. And I appreciate that. Not that everybody else here looks like bums, but they do. And so I appreciate that. You know who really appreciates it is Joe. And so
he does appreciate it.
You'll get to meet some of Amber. I think we're on a call with the accountant, actually.
Hi, this is PJ Braun. I have a call with Steve Karp.
One moment.
I'll make this fast.
No problem.
He's had that music forever.
PJ.
Hi.
How you doing, buddy?
Good. How are you, Steve?
I'm okay, thank you. What's going on?
Nothing. I have Amber, my bookkeeper, here, and you know, everybody was kind of confused of what everybody's responsibilities were, and
yeah, that's why I noticed that, and when I saw Amber, you know,
mm-hmm.
I got a quick file, you know, if she's there, it makes more sense for her to handle as much as possible, and if you want us.
No, I'm exactly with you on that. The whole Amber thing, you know, this goes back to the getting rid of Howard and everything else. And, you know, I didn't know that things were going to, of course, play out in my life the way they did. So, you know, before that happened, I figured, okay, we'll just have Steve Karp help as much as possible. But now that we have Amber here, you know, I sat down with her and I said, you know, it would really make sense if you have the time to please do for Celestial Bodiez what you're doing for Blackstone Labs.
You literally have 100% of our Amber, and we just do your personal tax return. We'll talk about LDFIT in a minute.
Okay.
Okay. But we'll do your personal tax return, which includes Celestial Bodiez, because that's just part of your personal. And we can get involved in tax projections at the end of the year. Or we can do monthly or quarterly oversight reviews, meaning Amber will send Elvira the QuickBooks files on a regular routine basis. We'll look at it, we'll make adjustments, we'll make comments so that Amber can make adjustments. We're here for Amber's assistance if she needs any, and handle it that way too. It just provides an additional layer of oversight. That's nothing against Amber. I mean, I do it for clients that have full charge bookkeeping, or, you know, multiple people in their bookkeeping department. Or we do the very bare bones and the minimal. We also want to just make sure that Amber's going to be taking care of the sales tax return for Celestial Bodiez so that nothing's overlooked. If that's, I don't know what you want to do. So that was the reason for me sending an email, because you had made a comment you wanted to go back to before, you know, Howard. And we were doing everything for Celestial Bodiez up to a point, and the other accountant was doing the same thing. But if you had somebody in-house, such as Amber, my recommendation is you use her, and then use us for tax returns and oversight projections and, you know, communication throughout the year and implementation throughout the year.
I mean, that's exactly what I was thinking, so.
And also, you will get to meet little Lizzie.
So this is Amgen. Awesome, awesome, awesome product. I'm gonna give you a couple things. Like,
okay.
If I was like coaching you,
yeah.
Like what I would want you to do, based on what you told me. Intergen, awesome. And then growth. Take this at night before bed. It'll make you sleep better, but it'll also make you release more growth hormone while you sleep. So by doing that, it will help strengthen your skin, your hair, your nails. You'll actually burn more fat, and it'll help you with recovery as well. So this is for muscle building. This is for recovery. And then, have you ever tried any of our pre-workouts before?
No.
Do you use a pre-workout now?
I don't really use pre-workouts.
Are you like somebody that's like sensitive to caffeine?
Yeah, not really like caffeine. I just get anxiety attacks.
Yeah, so do I. perfect then, that's actually good. So you definitely don't want this. That will give you a guaranteed anxiety attack.
I've seen a lot of girls on Instagram with those.
And very strong. The Hype is an awesome product. No caffeine.
Oh.
So I made this for people that want to take something to get a really good pump but don't want the caffeine.
Oh, okay.
And so if you take this before you work out, you'll get a really, really good pump. It's a really strong vasodilator, so it opens up all your blood vessels.
Oh.
So you're able to get way, way more blood in the muscle. And you'll feel it. You'll be like, you'll like it a lot. So no caffeine, you don't have to worry about the anxiety. Can I steal one of these?
Yeah.
Thank you. I mean, let's throw up a few things in here, just so she doesn't have to have it all in there. And I mean, your main goal is putting on muscle, right?
Yeah, correct.
Are you using any supplements at all?
I was using a potassium supplement.
That's just a vitamin, though, really.
Yeah, but it gets you, like, your blood flowing or something. So it gives me, like, a pump at the gym.
This will blow that away. You'll see.
Yeah, so I was like, oh, like, I leave the gym and I'm like, no pump. I'm like, what is this?
You're gonna love this. We put strong products.
Yeah,
that's why we have such a big following.
Yeah.
More energy. And then this is the other one I took it out.
Thank you.
Wait on that one.
Okay.
These first. I'll explain all this another time. This is done through liposomal technology. It's like really advanced. Like we're the first company that came out with this. And it literally takes 4 weeks just to make that product because it has to sit for a while. But that technology is really neat. It takes regular DHEA, which people have been taking for years. You know, it's very basic. It takes that and just through a two-step conversion, converts it into a really strong, you know, muscle-building product that's like not steroid but close to it.
Yeah.
And it's completely legal because it's DHEA. Now, DHEA by itself doesn't really do that much. You take a shitload of it and it's like not gonna do that much. Now, with the liposomal technology, completely different. But I would do the intergenin first.
Okay.
Because that's like the advanced stuff. Now, I'm not saying that you can't do it, but I'd rather see how you do with the antigen first, because I think you're going to be pretty pleased. And like I said, like we have so many girls that tell us like, oh my God, like I love antigen, like I'm getting so much stronger and like my booty's growing. And you know, I'm like, I don't know why, like, you know, it's not just making your booty grow. Like I'm sure everything is growing. You're just paying attention to your booty more.
Exactly.
You know? Probably training it 5 times a week.
A fan that came to a tour. You know, we always do tours here, gave her a little tour. She was nervous about asking Celeste for a picture, but I reeled her back in and she got her picture. And then you get to have a workout, a back workout. And I wasn't going too hard because I hurt myself playing basketball, but still gave you a little back workout action.
Try to save them, haunted by screams. childhood I cannot flee. I've got tormentors for lifetime.
See, I am still training hard, and then we went to Santos.
Get a little sushi. You gotta pace yourself. That's the name of the game here. You get too much on one plate, and then you just get overloaded. And you want different shit, and then you got it all on your plate already. You know what I mean?
The plate's empty. Just starting.
It wasn't like it was a huge issue.
Yeah, no, it's key. If you can find somebody that's a healer, like Flex's girl Jess, yeah. She's a healer. She's awesome. But she's like, I had her working on me every week, and then she disappeared. You know, and you know, I have a girl.
You got to stay consistent.
Yeah. I have a girl that's really good, Deanna, but she's not a healer. You know, like she'll relax you, she'll help you. You're not gonna fix, like somebody like that can literally help you fix your injuries, you know?
Well, he's strong, dude.
Yeah.
He's definitely got some strong hands.
No, that's key. Especially like, I have old injuries. So like,
yeah.
I need somebody that can go really deep. And you know, he's very good. He's like really like perplexed by me. Everybody that works on me always is. I have like.
You said you have like zero pain.
Yeah, it's really weird. It's not a, like, I tell people, like, I'm not, like, bragging. It's actually a bad thing, because it's why I've gotten hurt so bad so many times.
Just
yeah, like, he was like, working on my psoas, and he was, like, literally, like, driving his fist, like, almost through my body. And he looked at Salvina and Celeste, and he's like, this is blowing my mind. He's like, people are usually, like, freaking out. I don't understand how you're still texting on the phone. And I'm like, if I stop texting, I'm going to have so much more work to do when I'm done. So I just focus on what I'm doing.
Santos 2 days in a row.
I did. Week, whenever we have guests in town, we go to Santos.
That's like the place. Like after either after a photo shoot or if someone's in town for a few days, whether they're an athlete, family, friend, we always like force them to go to Santos. We're like, you'll love it, blah, blah. And then they always want to go back for a second time before they leave. It happens every single time. Mm-hmm. So they have something for everyone there.
Friday was the shoot. And so the shoot was featuring Lindsay. And so Cody is so awesome. And I've had some bad luck with some bodybuilders in the past. And that is why I signed so many women. However, Cody is, he is what you want. He loves the products. He loves bodybuilding. He is loyal. He believes in the brand. He believes in what he's taking. And because of that, he really does a lot with everything. And
he's a really good kid.
You know, I hope that he stays that way forever and doesn't change. And I wanted to give a little extra thanks back to him. And he has a very, very sweet girlfriend. And it's extremely difficult to be a pro bodybuilder. And I always said, either you have to be single, or you have to have some of these guys find these wives that are just like their moms. And it's crazy, man. It's like they do everything. They do all the cooking, all the cleaning, everything. That guy just bodybuilds still. So if you don't have one of those scenarios, you should not have a girlfriend. However, he managed to find a girl that is super, super supportive, does what he does also, helps him out so much. And
and she's pretty to boot.
She also looks awesome. So I said, you know what? Let's make her the star. Why don't you pop out of the spotlight for a second and let's make her the star. And we gave her an awesome photo shoot. She's a beautiful girl. She's very photogenic. And we got Cody, or she got Cody, I should say, to get in for some very cute couples pictures. And they did some romantic stuff at the beach, too. They steamed it up a little bit.
We'll be right back.
had a stain in the water holding that little reflective deal.
Yeah, I think you guys will see some of that. I don't know too many president slash CEOs out there who will stand in the ocean holding a light just for the sake of their athlete's picture.
He does it all. He really does. I didn't get to go to that, but I saw the pictures and the videos, and I was very pleased.
It was very hot that day, too. Monday. So this is, we spanned this one over a whole week, which was yesterday. You'll get a little bit of David and I talking about the upcoming photo shoot.
This is a very important shoot. It's arguably our most important shoot since the beginning.
Yep.
And since we're going to have a bunch of girls here, and the caliber of girls here, with exception to Carrie June, not because she's not amazing, but just because she's like a kid to me still, and I don't want her mom like having issues with this, but I have this vision of, somebody had said to me, you love one pieces and onesies, you always shoot your girls like that. And I was like, I do, don't I? And I was like explaining how hot, like I think that is. Got some really hot shots of Cody's girlfriend in the black onesie. And you know, because like a bikini is a bikini, it doesn't really leave much to the imagination. And you know, if a girl has like a serious booty, you know, and you have that onesie, you know, you turn around and it's a thong in the back, or if it's a Brazilian cut, I mean, it's a hot look. And it takes like a woman to pull that shit off the right way, you know? So with Monique and Samit and Celeste, like you got some thickness there. I mean, those two, Monique and Samit with the booties. So I was like imagining them, I was just visualizing like Monique in a black one piece and Samit in white. And I was like, damn, that looks so hot together. Like the yin yang, you know? And I'm like, we should do this with all the girls and just configure them in all sorts of different ways and just call it black and white. And then shoot some of it in black and white also and see which ones we like better. So like literally just black or white onesie, but always configured where it's black, white, never two whites next to each other.
Yeah.
And having the contrasting looking girls also try to figure out different backgrounds and settings. And I told Celeste, I was like, honestly, this is so like good of an idea because it's so basic, but it's the caliber of girls with it. Like I might want to just take this and get like 10,000 calendars made and just be it like girls at Blackstone Labs, like that we give away with certain amount, like $100 orders or $200 orders or something like that. Or maybe I'll want to sell it, but it's the kind of thing where I think people will really want to look at that. Because she was like saying a while back how she wanted to do a calendar, and I was like, calendars are not what they used to be. They're good like as giveaways in certain ways, or you know, extra like promo material. Like if you are going to do a calendar, like it's got to be something that people have a real reason to want this calendar, you know?
I don't know if you want to talk a little bit about that. There's a monstrous photo shoot coming in 2 days.
Do I? I always stress myself out really really bad with these huge shoots because not only do I direct them, I'm also in them and I plan them from the beginning to the end. So that goes from scheduling makeup artists, hairstylists, photographers, and then making sure the athletes come in and we schedule all of their stuff right, and then I have to get certain looks. We're basically going to try to recapture some group shots like we did with our last very successful group photo shoot, and those are our most successful images for our marketing campaigns on social media. So we have this big extended release of the Lunar Series. We're releasing some new items, new colors, and restocking some of your favorites, so it's like a big deal. And we're also shooting the camo stuff, which will be here very soon. So it is a huge shoot, and we're kind of have tons of new images on the site, tons of new images of the girls, and we have like an all-star lineup of athletes. So I cannot wait for the shoot. I'm already stressed out about it, but it's gonna be really amazing.
It's gonna be really exciting. I came up with an idea based on all the girls that we were gonna have here. I'm not really gonna talk about it. It's a vision that I have. And if my vision comes to light, then you guys will hear a lot about that later. You also will get to see Claudia going for a ride in my SLS, which is back.
Would you like, not now, but in a little while, would you like to see how fast really is?
Yes.
I'll take, no, I want the shrimp. I don't care about your stupid mug.
Wait.
I think it's terrible.
Are
you asking if she got his email? The agency being
like this one's bad. This number,
which means 30 seconds. I just want to hear the comparison that you have of
put
this
your helmet
vehicle
on,
versus the Ferrari.
This says
so you went in the Ferrari.
Yes.
What we should do is put that video with this video comparison. You were not scared in the Ferrari, though. She did say she was not scared. Another thing that's sucky about this car is that it doesn't have the radar built in like the other one. So what we're going to do is we're going to drive out nice and slow. We're going to drive down a bit more, assess the scene, look for coppers, look for pigsters, and turn around and drag race it back. That's that. Any words for the camera before we go?
I'm gonna make it back.
Not scared. Too many cars to do what I really wanted to do, though, unfortunately. Oops. But still got to see.
How was it?
It was fun. We should go faster, though.
Yeah, there were so many people I couldn't really accelerate for very long.
And we'll close out by talking about the American Express debacle. I'm very, very disappointed with American Express. And if somebody from American Express watches this and is high up, assume that won't happen. Maybe they'll help me out, but most likely no. So we've done so much business with American Express that we were privileged enough to become Centurion members. And, you know, we've done many millions of dollars with American Express. And we've really run much of the business's expenses through American Express for 4 years now. And when Aaron left and I took over the CEO position, there had to be some changes to the banking and whatnot, and I simply said, hey, you need to make me the primary on the card now, and they said they could not do that.
We're just going to have to pay it down, I guess. Are they saying that there's going to be like a shut-off time, you know, date if we don't pay?
Cards aren't working already.
Well, the car, David thinks the Facebook ads will be shut off soon. My shipping stuff has already been shut off, so I can't ship anything under that cart.
Okay. Well, we gotta pay.
So we just kind of got.
We gotta pay. We gotta be conscientious of it. 15th of every month, or the 17th of every month, the bill comes in. We have to pay it by the 1st.
Yeah, I mean now we have. I mean I have the sign in and access to it, so I could watch it every day to see what's going on. Also, and just to make sure that we're all using not Aaron's.
No, I'm using his number.
We're using PJ's yes. card. This way, if we ever see something from Aaron, we know that it's something that we either missed or something that Aaron's doing. It'll be easier for everybody in the end, anyways.
I'll follow up with Chase today and see what's taking so long there. And I don't think that we're going to get any good resolution with American Express, as far as my card goes, though.
No, did you find out what card Salvini used? Or did James use his own card?
And this is what is so frustrating about that. When we signed up for American Express, for Blackstone Labs, we, filling out the paperwork, couldn't both write down the same thing. Really, only one of us was going to be in the primary position. And it's kind of funny, something so arbitrary like that, of being, who's gonna do it, you or you? I was like, you do it. And it was kind of funny because back then, the discussion of who was gonna be president came down to Aaron actually being nice enough to say, what do you want to be? And I said, I visualize myself as the president. He was kind of like, oh, I wanted to be president. Okay, fine, I'll be CEO. And that's how the paperwork was filled out. Well, they actually told me, since the paperwork is filled out with him as the CEO, and since he still is involved as an owner of the company, they can't change anything. And what I explained to them is that he is gone, and that I need to use the card all the time, and we use it for shipping and everything else, and he is not even here. I even got Aaron on the phone with them to say, no, PJ needs to have the primary on the card so he can use it for the Blackstone expenses, and still they have not switched it. So now I applied for new cards to start all the way over for the staff, and after one time using them, they were frozen. So I had to send all of my tax stuff in, all of my IRS stuff, to prove that yes, we need to be in the position that we're in. And the accounts were frozen, coincidentally, until today. Apparently today all the cards work. We'll see how long they work for, no clue what the limit was.
The good vibes out there, baby.
Basically went from having an unlimited card to nothing. And that's because of that, we were wiring like crazy. My dad's been doing bank wires all day long for the past couple weeks. And I had a meeting with Chase about what sort of credit system I can get with them, because I was so pissed off at American Express. So American Express, I understand if you are following federal banking policies, but something so arbitrary, you could have just switched it and made my life a lot easier.
My life has been like very stressed out about
it. It's annoying. We don't, you know, and then, you know, because the card is in Aaron's name, he is the only person that could actually pay the card. And so we have to now rely on a situation where we don't even have a login for it. He gave us all the login stuff, so we're able to go in and handle it all through there, but we actually were not permitted to switch it. And it's so strange to me. So Amex, not happy with you. I used to love you.
Curse you, Amex. Also, really quick, show them your shoes, your new sneaks. We went on a Nike ID and ordered new sneakers. And so far, he only got one of his custom pairs in. And I'm not even wearing mine, so I can't show you. Mm. But
it takes a while on Nike ID.
We're like really cute. And at night, instead of going out, we like log into Nike ID and just like customize shoes together.
That's kind of boring, but hey, that's what we like to do. And we did get a couple fun beach days in too. Guys, I keep saying this, I'll try to get more videos done faster. But I just have a little bit more workload lately. However, it has been a very pleasant place the past week or so. It's very organized now with the new bookkeeper and the new CFO, and it's been very exciting. And because of that, I am pursuing basketball. So I'll end it on that. As always, peace out, bye.
You're a baby. You're a baby. You think this is your time?